You have prepared a scene. There are trees in the background, and how can we animate the trees in this background? I mean, how can we give a wind effect to these trees? It is not possible to do this with rotation. For this, we will use a bend effect in After Effects. At the end of the tutorial, we will have made a tree that is really provided by the wind effect. This is how I prepared my workspace. As you can see, there are some objects in the front. There is a small graphic in the back, and our main focus is the tree here. By clicking on this icon, right next to the tree's eye, we can fill this area so that only the tree is visible. Now, we are going to use an effect in After Effects itself to make this tree sway back and forth with the wind. Under Distort, under Effects, there is CC Bandit effect. When you select this effect, there will be some dots on the scene. You need to drag these dots to the top and bottom of the object you want to bend. I drag this point under the tree, and I drag this one on the top. Now, I open rotation by pressing the letter R. When we rotate this, we won't see any effect yet. We need to edit the center point here first. I immediately take the anchor point tool and drag the center point, and control click and drop it so that it is right in the center. When we control click, it aligns to the corners, so we are not drawing in small details. When we move it to these points by pressing the control key, it activates the snap feature. Therefore, like a magnet, these corners attract anchor points and it started to rotate from the bottom point. But of course, this is not what we want to do. We will write an expression for this. We need to access the effect controls panel in After Effects. I'm here on the left side. If you don't see it either, you can select the effect controls option under Window. This panel will appear in your workspace. I press the Alt key on the keyboard. I click here once. When I click on this, the expression field will open. Here we enter the comp and value in parentheses. We write this here. We need to give the same expression to end. Here you see end. So, I copy this line with Ctrl A, Ctrl C, and click on end. Again, by pressing Alt key on the keyboard, click on the icon here, and paste it here with Ctrl V. When we do these things, our object may disappear. When I click on start, I will see the dots here. I drag these dots over, under, and above the tree, as we just did. When we do these things, you will see bend again in the effect controls panel. You will see the bend property. This bend property has a zero value on the side. When I decrease this zero value, when I increase it to the left or to the right, when you pay attention to the tree, you will see the tree bending. This actually brings us a little bit closer to what we want. Now, we need to give keyframes of this. I'm coming here. When the timeline is at the beginning of the workspace, I click on the keyframe icon on the left side of bend. When I click on this, I'm now starting to give animation, but it doesn't appear on the scene. To make it appear on the scene, I click once on the tree and press the letter U on the keyboard. When I press the letter U, it will display me the properties that have keyframes on the timeline. Therefore, since there is only one keyframe with the bend property on this scene, I will only see bend. Here, we already have the keyframe we just gave. This keyframe is still at 0 right now. I'm making it minus 20, or you can also make it minus 10. These values depend on how much you want to bend the tree. If minus 20 is too much, you can also do minus 10. Now, I move the timeline forward a little bit more, and this time I make it plus 10. So what does that mean? It will go back and forth between minus 10 and plus 10. So there will be an animation like this. It is very slow. Yes, I agree. We can narrow it down a bit more. Let's see now. We start at minus 10 and we have a movement towards plus 10. Now, to repeat this movement, we could copy the keyframes and duplicate them here one by one. But this is not the right way. We will write an expression and it will move these keyframes by the length of the layer. Again, I press Alt on the keyboard and click on the clock icon here. Our expression field opened. So, the area where we can write code has opened. I'm writing loop out ping pong here, which means make it repeat like a ping pong. As you can see, when I click anywhere on the scene and move it, we have made the tree swing left and right continuously. To soften these movements, we select keyframes and press F9 on the keyboard. Let me narrow this down a little bit more so that the movement on the tree is much smoother. Now we can add a little bit more rotation to make it a little bit more realistic. I select the tree and press the letter R on the keyboard, the R for rotation. So it opens rotation for me. Let's give this a keyframe. Let's press the letter U again on the keyboard. What did we say when I press the letter U? The properties with keyframes will appear here. Let's hover over the second frame. We can also hover directly over the second frame by clicking on the arrow here. Of course, let's give these values, the rotation values as -5 and +5. Give +5 to the second frame and -5 to the first frame and select both frames, then click F9. This will make the movement softer. Let's hover over band. Right click and select copy expressions only. Let's hover over rotation and click Ctrl+V. So, what have we done? We copied the expressions on the band and gave the same to the rotation. What was on the band? It had the loopout property. We applied the loopout expression to rotation as well. Let's select the second keyframe so that it's between the top two keyframes. And when I play it after making these edits, you will see that the movement is more realistic. There is a little movement. We can say that there is movement at the top, but there is also movement in the torso. If I want to display this with other graphics on the scene, I just need to remove the icon here. As you can see, I see movement here, and you can adjust the speed of that through keyframes here. So, in this tutorial, I showed how we can combine several methods to make this movement in the trees. You can also animate the trees and objects in the background in this way. Of course, there are many ways to do this. This is just one of them. That's all for this video. I hope it was useful. If today's video was useful to you, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.